fantastic. The judges are feeling the signal, so I'd like to welcome, please, Manana, the candidate from Georgia. And she'll be giving a speech on the topic Limited Infinity.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Today, the topic of my speech is Limited Infinity, and I've tried to take you on a journey of Limited Infinity. Thank you. We are, at the same time, connected and disconnected by one thing, the idea. The idea which created the world, gave birth to kindness and wickedness, war and peace, wisdom and stupidity. The idea which created us, you and me. But this very idea, the creator of everything, is also something that disconnects us. Because it gives us freedom of will, freedom of thought, freedom that can take us to different countries, cultures, feelings, opinions. But still, the origin is the same. The idea, the creator of everything. Last summer, I decided to make new friends. Friends who are rejected because of one reason. They are different. I began to work at the mental hospital, where I met a very special and genuine person named Vajra, aged 54, who one day imagined himself as Shakespeare, another day as Mozart, Chaplin, or Michelangelo. And the moment he became one of these great figures, he himself became great. He was living in a limited space, but as he told me, the voices and ideas of great artists have taken him to the infinity. Once when he was talking to me at Shakespeare, he told me, "And art made tongue-tied by authority. How can you imagine art, which is controlled. Art, where you're not allowed to express the truth. I can only imagine art that does not chain your freedom, but breaks the chains of nationalities, borders, languages. Art, where does not exist the biggest flaw of life, a lie. What do you think? If Mozart had lied even once in his music, would he be able to create the record? Is not his music as a whole a harmony? But have you ever seen harmony made up with deception and artificiality?" Then unexpectedly, he looked at me with a challenged face and told me, "Hello, my name is Charlie, and I want to give you an advice. Always insist on yourself and never imitate. Because the moment we start to imitate others, our inner individualistic and genius child gets lost." He said that and disappeared in the dark corridor of the hospital, singing to himself, "You find that life is still worthwhile if you just..." I've never seen him again. But the moment I heard the topic of the speech, the first person I remembered was my friend Vajra and his words. Vajra, who was so near to greatness. And really, what does it mean to be a great artist? For me, it means to be a person who through art can describe his feelings as if it is yours. You, who might have been born 2 centuries after and 1,000 miles away, but still felt exactly the same feeling at the very first idea. an artist uses art to describe this idea. Great artist brings us to God who has no country, no planet, no constellation.
Okay, I'd like again to ask for questions from the floor for the participant from Georgia.